Hello all, I am Pallavi Bhujbal, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Engineering at AISSM College, Institute of Technology. I welcome you all for this session. Now today we are going to start with the second part of LSR, link state routing. So in previous lecture, I already explained about the LSR. Introduction part I already covered that LSR has a two part in which first is the reliable flooding, which I already explained in the first part of this session. So, with the example also. So, today we will see the routing calculation. So, this was the part of first phase, reliable flooding, in which we updated, we created the LS information table for each route. Now, today we will go with the second phase of this routing. So the second process, we calculate the route calculation here by using the Discus-Raz algorithm. Means this process, second process is D algorithm, Discus-Raz algorithm. It has to use D algorithm to find the shortest path. So the algorithm is like this. So if we see line by line, if we we'll see this algorithm line by line. Yes, so the tree have to find out least cost tree. So first, yes, from here we are starting here. So first the tree, we have to find out least cost tree. So in this initialize root node will be tree. So whenever we are choosing this, so root node will be tree only. Then for the second line, which I written y equals to 1 to n. So for every node inside that network, we have to process this information. Then if that is only one node, then we can say the distance is 0. The distance is 0. If there is only y is the root, then we can say the root is 0. The distance is 0. If we go for the second condition, which is given here, if we have a neighbor for this root, the node have to find out the cost involved between their root road and the neighbor node. So this is the second condition. We go for the next, which is the third condition, else if, yes, the third condition, if we have no direct contact with the neighbor, then we have to add the infinity to that value. So this is the first process. Second process is repeat. You have to repeat. Yes, have to find out the least cost tree. For there, for every first node, for every node, so we can start with the here. For first node, we have to find out node with the minimum distance from the root node. Then here, we have to add that node to the tree. After getting that, after the adding it to the tree, and we have to check if there is any node which is having nearest, a small part, a smallest part between that neighbor. Okay. So then you can find out the Bellman-Ford algorithm here by this equation. Yes. So you can find out with the Bellman-Ford algorithm. Then we repeat this loop. Yes, we repeat this all route. We have to repeat this process until you proceed with all other node. Okay. So we will see an example, then you understood this D algorithm. Again you see one by one process here. So here the first is tree. Yes. Initialize there is a root. For all the node inside the tree, we have to check for the three conditions. In that first, yes, in that first there is a root node, the distance is 0. If you have neighbor, second condition, if you have neighbor node for this road, you have to find out the cost involved between the, yes, between this
the two nodes. Third condition, third step for this algorithm is, if there is no direct contact with the neighbor, then you have to set the values to be infinity. Then you have to repeat. First you have to find out the nearest minimum distance node, then you have to add that value here, and for every node x which is the neighbor with the minimum distance, for each then the particular node, then add the node, that node to the tree likewise. So have to repeat one by one, and you have to add every other node to the tree. Okay, at last we will get the least cost tree. This is what your Dijkstra's algorithm. Now in next part we'll see how we are going to do this process with the example. Okay, thank you.